can be probably, that's a big, where you can do that. But if you can't make him make a step, you can't grow him, okay? And there's a couple of ways. I like to just, I'll skip back hard with this foot, just a little bit with this foot like this. See how this foot moved a lot, but it put all of my body weight in action. And it made, it made his foot, if I do it right, you see, if I do it right and skip the right direction and use my body weight, I can make him step. See, this is what I want. And then I switch directions. Take this other foot back close to the one to drive. And I hook, I don't hook and lift. I hook it wide. I leave it on my heel to make him do splits. Boom. Sorry for throwing it on. So that's my setup. We're not gonna work the setup. We're just gonna have the guy stand with his left foot forward. If he stands with his left foot forward real wide, any kind of way, sometimes you can fake a forward throw. He'll step forward, not fall forward. And you go this way. As well. Now I want some kind of chest contact. I want my belt to be lower than his when I come in. Belt lower than his. Support foot comes in. I want to drive up and hook out. Boom. Like that. Now don't want to lift his leg like this. Lift your leg like this. He's got pretty good balance. He can hop forward and backwards. I want to lead with my heel and take his leg out. Yeah, take your leg out and keep your balance. Do that for me. It won't work, right? So how many of y'all have seen this in the gym? Ever seen that? That's because they're hooking up and back. Okay, if you do it right, and get chest contact and hook outward. There's no hop, right? You're doing the split. And then I make his leg go out, and then I drive his weight where that leg would be. You see, but the leg's not there, so they have to pop. Let's see what's going on. No, to what I'm teaching. He's teaching him fall. I'm going to come check on what you're doing over there. So when I ask him about the fall position, I want him to know proper back fall position. Chin tucked, arms at 45, knees up, same side. Okay? Yeah, 10 minutes. Okay. So that's the basics of it. Somehow, some way, I got to make him step that foot forward. And usually I want him to be wide. His feet are in relation to my line of attack. If his feet are close together, right here. Now probably that's time. See how I don't have good power? Guys. Okay, guys. So I need his feet wide apart, this leg relatively close to me. And if I can get his feet where they're sort of on a parallel line, so my perpendicular, we're like a T. You see, he's the top of the T. I'm the bottom of the T. You're this T. So that's what I want to hear. And yeah, there's lots of different ways. It's pull, jump in, move. And that's if you do this right, you don't have to, some people do like this, smacks their opponent. You don't have to do that. It just needs to be the weight of the chest. You gotta get his leg out just enough to hook it and pull. accept it real hard.
Okay.
And then you can do the scrub even if you're not that good. I'm gonna break the step. You just do the real work.
That's that steamroll version I was talking about.
Come on, say that. Lower your level. There. Good. Come on.
Okay,
everybody's in the first. That's what I told you before you did.
great time. It's been good. Bottom arm straight, bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Now lift up. Bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Good. Twist. Bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Good. Sweet. Bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Good.
Look at me.
Yeah, I want to watch you. I'm going to look at you. Keep your chin tucked. Bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Bottom leg straight, bottom arm flat. Ready?
Look at your head.
Go right. Hey, you know you're right from your left. That's good. Slap a little close.
Why did you get that?